coming at you all the way from beautiful Southern Illinois, the 51st state. It is the Informal Radio Show on a Tuesday night for some odd reason. How you doing over there, Thomas?
I'm doing good. It's good to be back.
Well, it is good to be back, ain't it?
I missed last week's episode, but...
Yeah, it's good to have you back, man.
It is what it is.
I missed you. Life, I don't know if life anybody just, else did, but
life
I did.
Oh, I hope so. Sometimes life just becomes too much, and you just don't have enough time in the day.
Well, yeah, sure, man. Shit happens.
Yep. But on a Tuesday night.
Right. That was a little bit of Electric Light Orchestra there for you. Hold on, I got to take a drink.
How was your weekend? Was it good?
My weekend was great, man. I had a fucking fantastic weekend.
You guys played over there at Tequila Sheila's, didn't you?
Yeah, we did. Yeah.
Nice.
Friday and Saturday night, we had a good crowd both nights, and the band played great. We were all on top of it both nights. Wanted to give a shout out to all the people that showed up from Wayne County to come out and see us. We're glad you all came, and we had a fantastic time.
Nice. I was going to come out, but...
Yeah, I figured you probably got busy or something.
It's just not enough hours in the day to finish what I need to do.
Well, that's the way it works, man. That's fucking life.
Yeah.
Well,
it only gets harder.
Speaking of life, I'm sitting here getting my spirits up. I'm drinking it's called Cabin Fever. It's like a maple bourbon.
Yeah, I tried that the other night, and it was good.
Yeah, I had you try it the other night. Yeah. Yeah, it's got, I mix it with Sprite, that lemon-lime offsets that maple. Oh, that's good. Mm-mm-mm.
Sorry, I'm moving the beer bottles around over here.
Those are my dad's. They've been
there's only about seven of them over here.
That's my dad's. Well, I want to start this show off with some really dark, unfortunate event. Do you remember hearing about that little 7-year-old girl from, I believe it was from Watson, Illinois?
Yeah, I remember reading about it.
Yeah, where she went missing. Well, they ended up finding her body last night.
Really?
Yeah, they had found a body, and they confirmed that it was this little 7-year-old girl whose name is, Willow Long. They found her body. And, unfortunately, she was dead, so...
Yeah.
It says, the story is, this is out of, this is from KMOV over in St. Louis. This happened in Effingham County in Watson, Illinois, which is just south of Effingham. And, this hits pretty close to home for us, because Watson... I think it's a town of, like, man, I don't know, 720 people or something like that.
Yeah, 720-750, about that.
Yeah, so, anyway, it says they finally found a suspect. Matter of fact, they found a suspect right off, so they must have already had...
Suspicions,
yeah. So, because it says, a man faces charges after he allegedly killed his 7-year-old niece who had gone missing from her home in Effingham County over the weekend. Police confirmed the body of Willow Long was found by four search volunteers in an area south of Watson, 7:30 p.m. Monday. So this happened. They found the body yesterday.
Yeah.
Her uncle, 22-year-old Justin, I believe that's Derrick. Derrick, something like that, was arrested at 5:55 a.m. Tuesday. So he was arrested this morning. Authorities said he would officially be charged with first-degree murder Wednesday, and possible more charges will be filed. Says authorities said that Derrick would make an initial court appearance the same day. No other arrests have been made. Additional information regarding his arrest was not immediately available. An autopsy confirmed Long's identity, but her exact cause of death remains unknown. All indications are that it was a homicide.
Hmm.
Neighbors said officers put up crime scene tape around Long's house near the intersection of Circle Drive and Watson around 10:30 p.m. Another crime scene was set up with about a dozen officers on scene south of Watson, close to the Little Wabash River. That's where the neighbors said the body was found. And it says the arrest comes a day after more than 400 volunteers were in Watson to continue their search for Long. Authorities say the girl's mother discovered her daughter was missing after taking a 90-minute nap. When she got up, Willow's toddler brother pointed at the door. Within hours of her disappearance, a team of 500 volunteers and emergency responders began combining a 20-square-mile area. Began combing a 20-square-mile area. Man, I can't read where the shit. they were looking for the little girl, you know.
Yeah.
So, the story goes on and on. And I'm not going to go any further with it because it's basically just repeating the same thing over and over again. But anyway, they arrested her 22-year-old uncle.
Yeah.
I don't know. 22-year-old uncle.
I don't know what would cause you to do that.
Man, this girl was 7 years old. She had her entire life ahead of her.
Yeah.
And she... children are innocent, and I don't care what anybody says. Children are innocent, man. And her 22-year-old uncle fucking killed her. He killed her. For what reason? To be honest with you, I don't want to know.
No.
I don't want to know. There's no justification of why he did it.
No.
But
not at all.
But... I don't want to know what happened. I just hope she didn't suffer.
Yeah.
You know, no kid deserves that. That's just, you know, it's a sick fucking world out there. There's sick fucking people. Yeah. And that right there hits close to home.
Yeah.
Anyway, my respects go out to this little girl, Willow Long, and
her family.
All of her family. Yeah. All of her family and her little school friends and everything that... my total respects go out to that entire family right now because they're going through
hell.
And back. Oh, you bet they are. That hell don't even touch it right now for them people.
Because they're probably thinking the same thing. What would cause him to kill her?
Yeah, no.
Like,
kidding.
What would possess him to do that?
You know, like I said earlier, just a few minutes ago, I have some suspicions on what happened. And I'd hate to think that that's what it was, you know. Yeah, and that's the reason why I said I don't really want to know what, because, it gives me chills. Anyway, we're going to get off this subject. We're going to get on a lighter note here. Man, you know, I got hired at that Hoosier Stamping.
Yeah. Did you like it?
Yeah, I liked the job. I really did. I mean, it was during the day. The work was fairly easy. It was air conditioned. The people were nice, but there was this one boss that
you always have that one.
You
boss.
Always have that one guy, don't you?
Yeah.
It never fails. He's just I wouldn't consider him an asshole, but I would definitely call him a prick,
douchebag.
Yeah, a jackass. No, he he just always walked around like he had a chip on his shoulder. And anyway, I was working there through a temp service, and I worked there for about 2 weeks, and I received a call on a Friday that said your job's over, you and the other three gotta go.
Yeah.
You know, I'm like, well, I kind of figured at some point this was going to have to come to an end. I didn't really expect it to...
Since you're a temp, yeah.
Yeah, but I mean, I didn't expect it to come that quick.
No.
Well, now they're hiring again.
Hmm.
For full-time.
Huh.
And I got a phone call. It said, why don't you go back over there? And I thought, no.
AirTex is doing that, too.
Yeah.
They're hiring temps to get through their... When they have too much stuff to get out, you know?
Yeah.
When they have to go on 12, they'll bring a bunch of... Or 10 hours or whatever.
Right.
They'll bring in some temps.
They'll bring in temp service. Fill out the order.
Because they can use them and they don't have to hire... They don't have to, like, bring people back just for, like, 2 weeks and then let them go again. They'll just bring some temps in there and...
Right. The temporary service... the company doesn't actually pay them.
No. So they don't even care. Like, they'll use them until they're done and kick them out the door.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
And that's pretty much what happened to me.
Unless you're lucky and the people decide to bring you on full time.
Yeah, with the,
out of the temp service.
Well, I was going to work there at that Hoosier Stamping, trying to, you know, but I come to find out that their higher on rate from temp service is pretty low. So yeah. I thought, well, this is dead end.
Yeah, I've had to deal with a couple temps.
Yeah,
and they're
Well, you know, I got the experience, I guess.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not saying anything bad about temp services. I mean, there's some people that go through temp services and get really good jobs.
Yeah,
just the ones that I've had to deal with, there's a reason why they had to go through a temp service to get a job.
Yeah.
If you know what I mean.
Yes, I do.
They weren't all there in the head.
Yeah. And they weren't all there in the clean pee thing either.
I don't know.
Some of them that I've talked to.
When I had to deal with him up there at the elevator, we had one that he was just old and weird. And I mean weird. Like
really weird?
No, like, he was one of those too much information man kind of guys.
Oh.
Yeah. We knew whenever he brought edible panties that...
What?
That it was, yes.
Edible panties?
Yes. Yes. He got a little too... He got a little too comfortable around us.
Oh, he fucking wore the panties?
No. I don't even remember how we got on the subject. We were talking, and he was talking about how freaky him and his old lady got. That he was dating somebody from Evansville and got
how
a little
freaky.
How old
was he?
60-something.
Oh, dude.
Yeah, he might have been in his late 50s. He was strange. He was a strange guy. And
oh,
I don't
my
know.
God.
As soon as he brought out the edible panties one day and was talking about bringing a dildo, that's when we went and talked to Carrie and was like, you got to do something about this guy.
He's
kind of freaking us out. Yeah. Yeah. And then the other one.
Oh, shit.
Then we got another one in there. He was there for maybe 2 hours because he drove the tractor and I guess he farted and sharted himself and
he pooped his pants in the tractor.
And then he parked the tractor right in the middle of the road and like right in the middle of the road right outside the building and went in there and told the two girls in there, he's like, I shit my pants, I'm going home. And so I parked behind there waiting.
Are you serious, Thomas?
Not even kidding, man. That tractor smelled horrible. So I waited for, you know, like 2 minutes, and then I radioed into the main office. I was like, where's he at? And they came over the radio and said, he shit his pants. I was like, what?
He's like, shit his
he came in here just
pants.
A little while ago and said he shit his pants. That he farted and the little and shit came out, so he went home. And I'm like, wow. Wow. I was like, so I guess I got to move this tractor. They're like, please and thank you. So I had to get out and move the tractor. And yeah.
Oh, shit. He fucking shit his pants.
That's my latest of. That's when I was working at the elevator. That's my temporary help stories.
Yeah, sounds like fun.
Yeah. Yeah.
I wonder if he had a steak dinner before that.
I don't know.
Like a, you know, a steak dinner with potatoes all gratin, and gets in there and in the tractor and he's riding along and all of a sudden he's like, oh!
It's just like after he went home and we figured out what happened and we laughed at first break. We were just like, what? And the lady was like, yeah, he came in here and told us he shit his pants. I was like, okay, first off, I would not go in there and be like, hey ladies, I shit my pants. I need to go home. I would go and say, hey, Carrie, come here. I farted and a little poop came out. I need to run home. Give me, you know, I'll come back at lunchtime and work the rest of the day.
I wouldn't even do that. I just walk up and say, I gotta go home.
Yeah. I gotta go home. I'm not feeling too good. I might come back at lunch.
I gotta go home. I'm not feeling too good.
Don't even, I don't know.
I ain't feeling too
good.
Yeah,
he lasted about 2 hours. 2 hours, that's about as long as he lasted. He lasted long enough for us to train him on how to drive the tractor. Honestly, he lasted long enough to train on the tractor, and then he shit his pants and he had to go home.
I pooped my pants.
Yeah.
I pooped my pants.
Yeah. It's like, dude, why would you even... verbalize that to make that known to everybody.
How do you like your steaks?
Not bloody.
Well, like we're going from poop to steaks.
We're going from poop to steaks.
We're up in the ante a little bit.
Yeah, I like my steaks where... Yeah, I'm not the kind of guy where wipe it its ass and slap it on the plate. I can't do that.
Oh, shit, dude. I love it.
I have to have... I don't like red in my meat.
I want a medium or as bloody rare as... I mean, I want it cooked, but I want it...
I like my medium. Rare. I like my medium done. Like, I want mine done.
Not me, man. Yeah. What was that?
I think that was you burping or something.
Was it really? I didn't even
maybe
burp.
Maybe it was your throat, but must I know it wasn't me.
Must have been. I didn't even realize I'd burped. Anyway.
Wow.
Talking
about steaks is making your stomach all hungry.
It must be. No, I like mine. Have a lot of pink. I like mine rare, man.
I like mine when it's done and it's just getting done.
It's actually better for you to eat it rare. Did you know that?
It just feels like I get sick if I eat too much blood. I don't know why.
Well, but it's better for you to...
And it might be better for me, but I just don't feel good after I eat it. So.
Because then it doesn't cook all the nutrients and stuff out of it.
But see, I'm not much of a steak eater, though. I like my fish, my seafood and stuff.
I can tell, Thomas, you're 90 pounds soaking wet.
No, I'm 125 pounds soaking wet. Any other day, I'm about 115 any other day.
Yeah. Excuse me.
Yeah.
I weigh, I actually weigh 212 more pounds than you do. I weigh 200. I weigh about 180 some odd pounds.
I was
going to
say, I didn't think you were 300 and some odd pounds.
No. I'm actually under the 300 mark now. I have been under the 300 mark now for a while. I'm actually at like 289.
See, I thought
I'm pushing 300.
I thought you were at 280.
I thought
you went down to 275, 280.
I did, but I gained a little bit of it back, so I'm almost pushing 300 again, but I am staying down.
Stop drinking so much beer, man.
I can't help that. But I do get out, and I did lose a bunch of weight working over there at Hoosier Stamping. I was back down to at least 270 some odd pounds, but yeah. I'm back up to 289, 290 pounds, something like that.
Yeah.
So, but that don't stop
me. I'm going to be gaining some weight, but it's going to be muscle because I'm going to get back in shape.
Are you?
Yeah.
What the fuck's got into you?
I need to get back in shape.
In shape for what?
Anything.
Damn.
To do your mom. Just kidding.
That's not funny, Thomas. Yeah. I take serious offense to that.
Your mom's probably going to hear this.
I hope not. I hope she doesn't listen to my show because... Oh, yeah, she does listen to my show because I got a call once that said...
Yes. She
remember
didn't like
that?
The language.
She called the show.
She didn't like the language.
She didn't like the language.
She's like, Keith, I don't like the language on that show. You guys need to keep it more cleaner.
Yeah, fuck that.
It's like, God...
Like, fuck that.
Fuck that shit. Mother.
That's what I'm saying.
Fucking shit.
Yeah, pretty much. No, my mom probably won't be listening to the show, but my mom would probably call in about now and say, Thomas, in your dreams. You sick fuck. Talking about doing my mom. What the fuck is up with you, man? That's gross.
These freaking bottles over here.
Well, fucking move them. Do something about it. I don't know what to tell you.
I'll move them to the floor.
Okay.
So that we can break them.
Yeah, there we go. We'll go in and get the .22 rifle and set them out in the target outside. And
I've seen the target outside. Is that Ty's target?
No, that's mine. It's mine target? And my dad's. That's for our .22s and .38s.
Oh, yeah.
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 Did you not hear? Do you not hear me shoot the .22 every once in a while?
No. I'll have to bring mine down and shoot it one day. That freaking thing's loud.
I got this little bitty .22. Oh, it's a crack shot .22.
Do you shoot them little shorts out of them things?
Yeah.
Dude, I love them little shorts.
They're funner than fuck, man.
I've had pellet guns shoot louder than .22 shorts.
Oh yeah. These here are just like, psh,
yeah.
That's all it is.
They're good to go squirrel hunting on other people's lands.
Yeah, hell, because I'll tell you what's fun about it.
You can shoot them things that you can't. You can hear it, but you don't know where it's coming from, because by the time you hear it, it's
already there.
Yeah.
Hell, this little crack shot, man, it's about like this long.
Yeah.
It's the lightest little 22.
It's about 2.5 feet.
Oh, yeah, probably. And it's like, it's called a, I can't remember what the name of it is, but it's called a crack shot. It's a single shot. And hell, you load it in and pull the hammer down.
Yeah.
Pull the, it's a falling block. Cock it out.
Yeah.
Put the deal in there. Pull the block back up. Pull the hammer back. Aim it.
Yeah.
Man, it's so much fun.
Well, I'll have to bring down my 22 pistol. That thing is a 9-shot.
You got a little 22?
It's loud as all.
Semi-automatic or revolver?
Just revolver. It's a 9-shot. 9-shot revolver. Yeah.
That is really strange.
It's a shooting competition pistol. That thing is so loud.
Wow. Wow. I never did. Little 22s with short barrels. And 38s with short barrels. My dad's got that 38 Taurus in there with the short barrel on it. They are so fucking loud.
No. This thing has about a barrel on it about this long.
Oh, but it's still, it's loud.
It's just...
It doesn't have a rifle barrel.
It's ungodly loud.
Yeah, them little... I never did like the sound of the shots of those little guns.
I've shot like a Ruger, and those aren't that loud.
No,
I like them little Ruger. Those little Rugers are fun.
They're
fun little guns.
In my opinion, a 38 is a whole lot louder. It just has that crack. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
but
yeah.
You shoot like a 44 Magnum, and it's not. And it just goes cool boom,
smacks you in the head.
Yeah. It just cool boom.
Yeah.
Whereas a 38 goes, you know.
How did that go again?
Ear piercing. You heard what I did. You know.
Yeah.
Just pierces the fucking eardrum.
Yeah. Well, that's the 22 I have. You can even have like the earphones in your head.
Yeah.
And it still hurts.
Yeah, I have to wear earphones too when I shoot 38.
Yeah.
It just fucking blows my mind.
Yeah.
And it still hurts.
Yeah.
Even
we'll,
then.
We'll have to drink a little this weekend and shoot guns in the backyard.
I ain't drinking and shooting guns.
How come?
I ain't doing that. Fireworks, maybe. Guns, no.
Yeah, I still have about 3 blocks of bottle rockets from 2 years ago I need to use up.
I've got about 2 or 3 blocks, too.
We'll have to get some PVC pipe and make some shooters off. And
I'm thinking about getting like a fence gate. You know, like a chicken fence?
Yeah.
Setting it up on some stumps?
Yeah.
And putting all the bottle rockets down and putting a fuse with it?
Yeah.
All tied to one fuse?
Have to get some fuses. And
yeah, like a cannon fuse or something?
Yeah.
And light that cannon fuse and just let it like send off like 10,000 bottle rockets.
Yeah.
Does Boom Land over at Griffin stay open 24?
Yeah.
Like 24, like
yeah. Boomland is open all year long.
All year long, I mean, not 24/7. All year long, it really is.
Yeah,
I didn't know that.
Not even kidding, it is open all year long.
I didn't know that because see, I rarely see cards there.
Because you usually don't go randomly buy fireworks during the year.
Well, this motherfucker is going to.
You're having a party.
Well, this fucker right here is getting ready to do that exact thing.
Might as well, man.
Let's do that, dude. Like this weekend, I get up my next paycheck, and after I pay my bills, man, let's go over to fucking Boomland over Griffin.
Might as well.
Get some fireworks. Terrorize the neighbors.
Yeah. I always like to getting the mortars and then lighting them and throwing them like you'll
light
the big,
fuck yeah.
You light them and just throw them as hard as you can into like the street or something, and then watching which way they go.
Yeah, and hoping to God it don't come back to you.
Yeah, back to you or hit a house or something.
No
start
shit.
A fire. Yeah.
Remember that time we were all down here, and my brother Jerry had them mortar shells, and he set up the fucking tube and was shooting them in that shed.
Yeah.
We had that old tin shed.
Yeah,
they were fucking blowing up in there.
Yeah,
right.
Wasn't at the time you had the car in there? Didn't he open the door to the old blue car and try to shoot him
in the car? Yeah, I tried to shoot him in the blue car, yeah.
Yeah, I remember that thing. Your mom hated us going in that barn.
Yeah, because we'd always try to shoot it in that fucking Renault.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, hey.
Fun times.
It was fun times, but hey, I got to take a break.
Oh, yeah, that sounds good.
We'll be coming back in just a second.
We'll be right back. blanket when I was conceived. Been riding on an empty bus, not chosen by me. Been thinking in the background, how can I reveal the face behind those heavy hands holding the wheel? Who's driving this bus?
Couldn't figure out the controls there. God damn it.
It happens.
Anyway, this is off of our new album. This is me doing Who's Driving This Bus.
Where will this road lead the last of us? I need to know.
Remember when you come down and listen to the demo of this?
Yeah.
Turned out pretty good, actually. It actually worked out.
Did you ever figure out who's driving the bus?
Yeah, Uncle Jimmy's driving the bus.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That would piss me off if I still didn't know who was driving the bus.
Well, we figured out Jim is definitely driving the bus, but the song is alluding towards who is driving the bus of life.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. Sorry, I can't run the control board tonight. Damn, what the fuck?
It's Tuesday.
It's Tuesday, yeah. It's been a long day.
It sounds like when I'm gone, you can't run anything.
No, I can't.
You give the wrong date and all that good shit.
we're not going into that.
No. I think my church is broke. No, I'm serious. I think my chair just broke. This piece underneath here.
Really?
It just broke.
You fucking broke it?
I think I did.
Goddamn, Thomas, you did.
I wouldn't have broken it if you would have kept my damn chair.
You know what?
Chair. You took my chair, and I had to go get this chair.
What the hell, man?
I was fine with the chair you're sitting in right now. I was fine with that, but no.
What difference does it make?
You had to move
make?
The chair. And then you pulled something off the freaking... Ow. The speaker over here.
See, now who's laughing? Yeah. You hit your head on the microphone. Now you know how I feel. Well, here's my thing. Them chairs, that table and them chairs, my grandma said she got them back when my dad was a kid.
Oh, yeah?
So those chairs, all of that shit's been on there since probably the 1960s. And somehow, Thomas, you have managed to fuck it up.
No, this chair's already been broke. See this leather leg over here? This thing over here? I didn't do that.
Yeah, right.
I swear to you, I did not do that.
Hell, I got Loctite inside. We'll put it back.
Yeah.
We'll take care of that pretty quick.
The red Loctite?
No, the blue Loctite.
Why? The red's stronger.
Well, but the blue Loctite, I've got stuff that'll react with it.
Because the blue Loctite says, I'll hold a little bit. But the red Loctite says, oh, hell, I'll hold everything.
Yeah, sure does.
You can hold a door on it. On a truck while you're going down the road. Doing 90 miles an hour.
Really?
I know.
I was going to say, Thomas, have you tried that?
No.
Oh, well, then how do you know? See, you can't say that the red Loctite is stronger and then give reasons why and then them not be true. See, the thing with the blue Loctite is I've got this stuff that I can like spray on it and it'll cause it to harden immediately.
Oh, yeah?
And it goes, psst. Yeah. Ooh, excuse me.
You just coughed.
No, I'm sneezing. Now you're sneezing.
I hate these little gnats.
Yeah, they're fucking everywhere,
they're
man.
They're flying all over me, and it's making me mad because...
They're everywhere. Everybody's house that I've been to, there's gnats. These little gnats.
Yeah.
I think they call them pecker gnats.
Yeah. Because it's that or these spiders. These spiders are everywhere this
year.
Yeah,
them great big spiders.
Yeah, we've had spiders... Overrun by frogs.
The little bitty frogs.
I know. The little bitty frogs and then the mosquitoes and these stupid gnats.
Oh, the mosquitoes have been horrible this year because it's been so wet.
Yeah.
But these spiders, every year.
The water finally went down, but they haven't migrated.
No.
And they're not big mosquitoes or these little bitty mosquitoes.
Yeah, you can't see them.
Annoying the crap out of me.
You know, it's like I was talking about these spiders. You notice every year, this time of year, we have these spiders that come around. But they're like in a huge abundance this year. You know, I call them banana spiders, but they're not really banana spiders. I don't know what they are, but they're like yellow and black, and they're like, you know.
Aren't those banana spiders?
They might be. I don't know.
You know what's making me mad?
It's not the spiders.
The gnats, okay, the mosquitoes, yeah. But we've had two freaking mice in our house for about 2 weeks now.
Oh, mice?
Yes. We put traps out. They won't take peanut butter. They don't like peanut butter. They don't. I've had chips in my room. They haven't ate my chips. You know what they eat?
What?
Snickers.
Snickers?
They got into my sister's Snickers. And they ate the crap out of them things.
Well, we put the wrapper and everything?
Yeah. We put an open Snickers. They ate all the chocolate one setting. He got trapped in it, so he drug it like 4 feet across the room, then finally got free. And then they came back. We put it back underneath where we had it, and he came back and ate all the peanuts and everything. He ate the rest of the Snickers.
I'll be damned.
Yeah.
I like Snickers.
They're making me mad. So we're trying everything. I think we got about 15 traps in between my room and my sister's room, just because, like, I don't know, they're stupid. So probably this weekend, that's what I'm doing, is I'm pulling everything off the ground and looking for them stupid things to kill them. I'm gonna kill them stupid.
You'll never find them.
They've been underneath my bed because I'll jump in bed at night and, like, move around.
And you can hear them?
And then I'll hear them run across my room.
Yeah.
Because I got that wood flooring in my room, and I'll hear them run across my room and over, like, my school books or something.
Right. Yeah. Oh, yeah. See, we don't have them that bad in the summertime. It's in the wintertime.
Well, see, we didn't have them until that backwater came up the last time.
No. Yeah, I see.
Yeah.
See, we didn't even have them then. But we do. We set out rat poisoning, too. But, the summertime...
We can't. My cat or dog will eat.
Well, true, yeah. But we put it under the house.
Oh, gotcha.
And we throw it in the crawl space, you know. Or we put it up on the counter. We don't have cats or dogs in the house. We have them outside. But they can't get under the house, right?
Yeah.
But we don't get them in the summertime like we do in the wintertime. In the wintertime, they come around... And they'll get in the drawers, and they'll shit in the silverware drawers, you know. And then I've got to take all the silverware out and clean it at least once a week.
Yeah.
And they'll eat, like, the little rubber, like we had, like I had a rubber, I guess, like for cake batter, you know, scraping all the cake
spatula.
Batter. Yeah, like it's like a spatula.
Yeah, that's what it is. It's a spatula.
Yeah, well, I guess, but it's rubber, and they'll eat that.
Yeah, that's called a rubber spatula.
Yeah, rubber spatula. Okay, whatever. Rubbers. Oh, I see. I don't. You know, it's a rubber sumbitch is what I call it. But anyway, they will eat that. They will eat the rubber tips on the ends of your spatulas.
Yeah.
Regular spatulas. They'll do that, and they absolutely love crackers and spaghetti. They like spaghetti for some reason. I can't believe that, but they'll eat spaghetti. And if you got spaghetti in your cabinet, they will chew through the box and eat the spaghetti. It's the most weirdest thing I've ever seen. But the dog and the cats will not... oh, that boobies? That's cute, Thomas. I like the little nipples in the O, in the O's there he drew. That's pretty inventive, Thomas.
I put a lot of thought behind that.
I was going to say, Thomas.
Did you see how all my... letters were capitalized until I got to my E.
But really, it shouldn't be the O's with the... should be more like this.
That makes them saggy.
Well...
Those are perky, and that's saggy. Okay, but continue with your...
Yeah, so...
Eating the rubbers.
Yeah, well, I was talking about the cats and the dogs. See, the dog just barks at
everything
and mice and shit like that. The cats will literally sit there and watch the mice run across the floor.
Yeah.
The mice will come up and eat the cat food. Mice eat cat food too. And the birds will come up. Well, the birds are coming up and eating the cat food and shit out of the pan. And the cats sit there and watch it.
Nice.
They are so lazy.
My cat's been eating my dog food.
Oh,
like
really?
My dog's dog food.
Jealous.
If Thor doesn't eat his dog food and there's still a little bit in there, she'll go and eat it.
Yeah, it's jealousy. It's a dominant thing.
Yeah. Either that or it just feels like
heavy. Maybe, yeah, that's true.
Because we feed him good. Like, we feed him the meat's the first ingredient.
Oh, yeah.
Kind of thing, yeah.
That's, what do they call
that's
that?
Why that's
pedigree
why
or whatever?
I don't know what it is.
Yeah, it really...
We get
really
it at... We get
fancy
it at,
stuff.
We got Emily's there and Albin, the vet.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Miss Emily.
I see. So, you get the really rich ingredient.
It's like $40 a bag.
Holy shit.
I know.
If it was me,
I'd just go to Walmart or Kincaid's and buy the 50-pound bag for $25.
Yeah, I was going to say, I spend like $25 a month on my dog.
Yeah.
If even that... And what's funny is We had to put up gates on our back deck because a dog will not eat dog food, but it will eat cat food.
Yeah. And that's where your cat food's food is.
Yeah. Yeah. It'll go around and eat the cat's cat food, but it won't eat the dog food. So we put up the gates. And I'll tell you what, I started getting the dog cheap dog food because that's all I could afford.
Yeah.
So I'm getting this dog cheap dog food. Wouldn't eat it for a month. Finally, it got hungry.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, you know, you can sit there and starve yourself, but here's food right here. And finally, it got hungry, and now it likes it.
Yeah.
So, but I thought about, why in the hell am I doing this? I can just go out and buy cat food. So I tried that, and the dog would not eat the cat food out front. You know, it would go around back and eat the cat's cat food, but it would not eat the cat food that I got for it. So
probably the scent.
Yeah. I don't know what it is. It's weird.
I don't know.
Animals are weird.
Pretty much.
Anyway, I'm sitting here drinking this. I'm drinking this the whole show. What's your favorite drink, man?
I tried that Evan Williams honey.
Yeah, that's what I got.
Stuff
over there
is amazing.
Yeah, Riley, who's on the show last week, he works over at McGahey's Liquor, and I told him I was at Tequila Sheila's there Sunday, and we sit down and we're drinking before we loaded out. Well, actually, we had other people load out for us because we were drunk. But anyway, I was sitting there drinking that, and I had that Jim Beam honey. Well, they
haven't had that.
It's great, and they had the Jim Beam maple, and it was great. But they didn't have that at McGahey's, and so I settled on the Evan Williams honey. And personally, I think that the Evan Williams honey is better than the Jim Beam.
I can't say offhand since I haven't had the other stuff. But this, I had for my birthday. My sister got me those little sample sizes,
right.
And I tasted that.
Airplane bottles?
Yeah, the airplane bottles, and I was like, wow.
Oh, yeah.
Amazing.
Man, you can drink it straight, man. Yeah, put it on rocks, man.
Just put some ice in there, pour it in a cup, and sip it, and oh my goodness, it's amazing.
See, that's why
You said it was good with Sprite. I haven't tried it with Sprite yet.
It's good with Sprite.
So I'm probably going to have to go buy some or come down here and
it's good with Sprite.
Glass of yours.
It's good with Sprite, and so is that maple. It's good with Sprite, too.
Yeah.
But the maple, I've been drinking this Cabin Fever.
Yeah, the Cabin Fever maple, yeah.
Yeah, I put it in the freezer over there, and once in a while...
If you're not used to it, it has that first little bite to it, but after that, it's good.
It'll kick your ass.
Yeah.
You got to be careful how you're drinking it.
Yeah.
Because that shit is... The thing about that stuff being so good is...
You'll drink a bunch of it,
before you know it, you're... Totally, yeah.
See, I have that trouble with Grey Goose and Absolute Vodka.
Oh, yeah.
Because it's so smooth.
Yes.
You can drink so much of it and not notice.
And not even realize it,
you know? Because you can shoot that straight, you know?
Sure.
And so you're just like, oh, that's good, you know?
Yeah.
Drink that and then go back to, you know, drinking a fruity fruit drink. And then go back to take another shot. And by the end of the night, you're like, where'd that bottle go?
Exactly.
Oh, gosh.
Well, here's what happens to me usually. I go to a bar, or even if I'm sitting around the table over there and I'm hanging out with friends and I'm drinking like vodka, and my favorite thing is vodka and Sunkist, man. Straight vodka and Sunkist. That's fucking fantastic.
Yeah.
Hell, I can sit there for, you know, about an hour and drink that. And then all of a sudden, I got to get up and go pee, and I think I'm fine until I stand up, and then I go, whoa,
well, see, whenever when I do the Sunkist, I always get the whipped cream vodka.
Oh, yeah.
And add that, and it tastes like a freaking orange sickle.
Like a dreamsicle?
Yeah, like a dreamsicle.
And oh, yeah.
It's amazing. I can drink that stuff a lot.
Sometime you got to come down here. Tracy came out the other night at band practice last week. Last Tuesday, I think it was, and she made pineapple upside down cake, and it was a drink, and it was cake vodka, grenadines.
See, I haven't had that cake vodka. I mean, you have like every flavor of vodka. I think they even have a bacon flavored vodka.
Yeah, they probably do. They have pickle juice vodka. Why the fuck wouldn't they have a bacon flavored? But anyway, it's cake vodka, UV cake vodka.
Yeah,
grenadines. Cherry syrup, pineapple juice, and a couple of cherries. And it tastes just like a pineapple upside down cake.
Wow.
Oh, it's good.
Wow.
And it's good. And I didn't
Do you add any pineapple juice or anything to it?
Yeah, it's pineapple juice.
I didn't hear you say pineapple.
Yeah, it's UV cake vodka.
Mm-hmm.
It's grenadines, cherry syrup.
Okay.
Pineapple juice.
Okay.
And a few cherries.
Gotcha.
And
so there's no mixing to it at all. It's just straight alcohol.
Well,
I have the hiccups.
Well, grenadines is not alcohol. Oh, the only thing alcoholic in it is the vodka.
Yeah. I don't remember what grenadines is.
Grenadines is just a cherry syrup.
Oh, vodka. Gotcha. Yeah, I remember.
I mean, it's for cooking.
See, that's what that my sister
for
has
baking.
Some of, my sister has some of that UV blue crap.
Yeah, see, I kind of like that UV blue.
I don't like it. It makes it taste too fake.
Is it too flavored. Sweet or too?
No, I mean, too fake flavored.
Oh, I see
like
what you mean.
You can only add so much of that to where the flavor is just off. You know, it makes it that fake flavored taste. And
yeah, I know what you mean.
That's why I can't drink cheerleader booze.
I see.
Some of the cheerleader booze I just can't drink.
Cheerleader booze.
Yeah.
I've never heard of that.
Mike's Hard Lemonade crap and that kind of stuff. That's cheerleader booze because you can
never
give,
heard of mention that.
You can give a six pack to a chick and she seems drunk at the end of it because she thinks there's so much alcohol in there when there's only like
cheerleader booze
3%.
That's different. I've never heard of called cheerleader booze before.
Yeah.
Huh.
Yeah.
But damn.
I know, right?
But no, that grenadines is what you use for baking and stuff. It's a very It's a cherry syrup.
I think we have that at the house, but we have like pomegranate.
Yeah.
And whatever, it comes in a big bottle.
Yeah.
And you never can seem to pour any out without getting it down the side of the bottle, and then the bottle gets all sticky.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Well, you know, it does not take very much. I mean, it just a splash.
Yeah. Well, see, I used to I'd get that with when I'd make my sweet tea. I'd just drop a little bit of raspberry in it. And have a raspberry tea.
Are that grenadines raspberry? Yeah. Yeah.
And it tastes pretty good.
Yeah.
But then you got grenadine, you got the vanilla and French vanilla. I used to put that in my coffee.
Right.
Until I switched to Bailey's ice cream.
Oh, yeah. Is that, is it alcoholic or?
Yeah.
But you can get the non-alcoholic.
Oh, yeah, you can get the non-alcoholic, but why?
Well, why? I personally like to start my day non-alcoholic.
Well, it's not enough. It's, I don't know. It's good, though.
Yeah, I'm sure it is.
I like it a lot. Because you can
I've
pour
had,
that.
I've had the both
you,
of them.
You can pour that in there, and you don't need to add your milk or anything, so.
I've had both of them, the non-alcoholic and the alcoholic, and you can't tell the difference.
Yeah. I mean, I like the, because I usually drink my coffee just black with maybe some sugar in it.
Right.
But then I started putting that Bailey's ice cream in there, and
I bet that is good.
That's my cream for you.
Ice cream or iced?
Yeah.
Iced cream?
What?
Is it Bailey's iced cream or ice cream?
Neither. It's Bailey's Irish cream.
Irish cream.
Irish cream. You know, like the leprechaun.
Yeah. I get it. Irish, you know, as an Irish?
Yeah.
Irish. Okay.
Irish cream.
Damn.
Not iced cream. Why would,
Well, hell, I didn't know. Maybe it's cream on ice or something.
I don't know. I bet you could put that into your when you're making some ice cream, just pour some Bailey's Irish cream into your maker.
Yeah,
freaking! Do you see all these flies flying around?
Yeah, I know, it's getting bad.
I'm looking at you, and there's like four of them flying around in between me and you.
Yeah, they're getting up my nose and shit. Yeah, it's pretty dumb. I'm
trying to eat your brain.
They must be.
What's left of it?
What's left of it? Yeah. Yeah.
Oh god.
Yeah. Well, it's about time to go. We got a minute left before 45 minutes, so.
I say we talk about people and their stupid laughs.
Oh, yeah.
Because I was listening to the Opie and.
Oh, you're listening to Opie and Anthony?
Anthony show.
They were going.
I almost said Opie and Andrew.
Opie
and Andrew. I don't know why.
Opie and Anthony.
Anthony's show, and they were talking, and that one guy on there just had the most. Yeah, it's the most annoyingest laugh ever.
There's like those guys that laugh. Some of them that go. And then you got them ones that go, ha, 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 ha.
That sounded like Bill Clinton.
Why?
That laugh sounded like Bill Clinton.
Bill Clinton?
Yeah. You know the president?
Yeah, but I mean, I don't know why I've never heard him laugh like that.
It just sounded a little bit like it.
To me, it sounded like Pee Wee Herman.
Oh.
Pee Wee Herman?
Yeah.
I'm Pee Wee Herman.
Why don't you jump on my little red bike? Sit in the back.
Jerry! Jerry! Guess what day it is? It's chili day!
Wow.
Well, we got to get out of here.
I guess it's time to go.
Yeah, we got to get out of here.
I'm ready to go to bed.
Are you?
Yeah, I'm tired.
Damn, dude. I can't believe that.
All right.
What are we going to take him out with tonight?
I don't know.
Let's take him out with Count Five, Psychotic Reaction.
Okay.
Hey, we're all glad you tuned in. We are so glad you all tuned in.
Even though it's a Tuesday night.
It's a Tuesday night. We meant to do it Monday, but we had things come up.
Yeah.
Well, I'm Keith Chapman.
And I'm Thomas Hubble.
And we'll come back at you next week again on the Informal Radio Show. That's right, you've been listening to the Informal Radio Show, coming at you all the way from beautiful Southern Illinois, the 51st state of the Union of the United States of America.
In a little white shack.
In a little white shack we call DoubleWide Debirs World Headquarters, also known as Dango Dick's Beer Garden. That's all I got to say about that.
Sounds good.
Hey, good night, everybody.
Let's get out of here.
All right.
Bye.
Copyright 2013, Eat My Dick.